From the blatant theft of her cells to the amazing research that has followed, stay tuned to number one to find out the real-life story of Henrietta Lacks. Number 10, Immortal Cells. We all wish to be immortal, or at the very least, to live a long and healthy life without fear of a sudden passing. But when it came to Henrietta Lacks, she had within her body something that could be defined as immortality, even though the definition that you were thinking of isn't correct in this context. Because Henrietta Lacks was not immortal, she passed away in the 1950s, but her cells, technically, were immortal. Or, more accurately, one particular set of cells were. You see, she was being treated for a type of cancer, and when her cells were sent to a cancer researcher who discovered that her cells would not only live on, despite various things happening to them, but that they could reproduce indefinitely. Now, the idea of immortal cancer cells probably doesn't sound appealing, but that's not what happened. The scientists used these cells as a basis to create various medicines. Much like how you use a virus to try to find a medicine strong enough to counter it. And her cells were a big help in the world, even giving her the nickname the mother of modern medicine because of the effect her cells had on the field of medicine. But in this case, this was one mother who didn't know she had a child. Number 9, consent. I want you to think about a great invention or discovery. It could be the telephone, electricity, the engine, whatever you want. Now, do you know who discovered or created this thing or construct? If you can, great. If you can't, you could very easily look it up. The point I'm trying to make here is that just about every major invention or discovery that the world has made has been credited to certain people because of their involvement with the project. It's only fair that we credit those who did very hard work, right? If you're wondering where this is going, well, I'm about to tell you. Henrietta Lacks was getting treated for cancer when her doctors made the discovery about her immortal cells. But instead of going to her and asking for more samples so that they could try to make more progress with it, they basically stole her cells and then sent them all over the world for other doctors, surgeons, and researchers to look over them and see what they thought of the endeavor. It was so bad that doctors from all over the world were examining her cells, and Henrietta Lacks herself didn't even know what was going on. In fact, her family didn't even know until long after she passed away. And when they did find out, the family was furious, as you'll soon find out. What did the research institutions and doctors have to say about this? Well, here's a statement made from John Hopkins 60 years after the deed was done. It's important to note that at the time that the cells were taken from Mrs. Lacks' tissue, the practice of obtaining informed consent from cell or tissue donors was essentially unknown among academic medical centers. Essentially unknown. In other words, they didn't have to ask back then, and they can prove it. But it doesn't excuse what they did, especially since the family soon found out about the practice of using Henrietta's cells, now known as the HeLa cells, because many people were curious about their source. This was a serious invasion of human rights. While it was fine to study her original cells as she was being treated for cancer, the widespread distribution of them was a breach of trust and confidence. If for no other reason, then Henrietta Lacks and her family received no credit, no financial royalties from all the medicine that was made from her cells, which are continued to be used to this day. If something like this were to happen today, there would be trials and hearings and firings all over the world. But because of loopholes and shadow games, that won't happen. Number 8. Her cells did indeed save lives. Before we talk about the amazing findings from within her cells, take a moment to like this video and join the Zero to Hero community by hitting that subscribe button below. Whether you condone what happened with the HeLa cells or not, there's no denying that some of the things that the cells did for this world at large has been largely beneficial. For example, polio vaccine, AIDS treatment, chemotherapy treatment, in vitro fertilization, gene mapping, and many more procedures and medicines were concocted because of the HeLa cells. Polio was once one of the most deadly and crippling diseases in the United States, and now it's literally a thing of the past. Chemotherapy has been a huge part of cancer treatments over the years, which is ironic as this was what Henrietta Lacks was diagnosed with. And though it's not 100% in its efficiency, It's an option, and one that many people take in order to at least attempt to beat their condition. As for gene mapping, the human genes are still a wondrous mystery of the world. Having them be mapped can help scientists and researchers come up with various ideas for helping create new medicines and vaccines, like what was done before. Though we don't know everything about the cells, as well as how we can manipulate them like doctors manipulated the HeLa cells, it's a start. It's better to have a map than nothing at all, right? It's still not an ideal circumstance how the cells were taken and used, but you can't deny that the results are one that have been beneficial to the world at large. Number 7. The Henrietta Lacks Foundation. While it took a while, the story of Henrietta Lacks did indeed spread throughout the world, and there's been some very positive things to have come from it, including the birth of the Henrietta Lacks Foundation. What does this foundation do? According to its website, it's about helping individuals who've made important contributions to scientific research without personally benefiting from these contributions, particularly those used in research without their knowledge or consent. Admittedly, this is a roundabout way of helping the family of Henrietta Lacks, of which she had a husband and several children, but there are others who are taken advantage of medically that need help getting a fair compensation. Founder Rebecca Skloot said, "I first envisioned it as a foundation for education, but I realized that the people who were affected the most were her kids, and they needed some medical care and dental care." You might be wondering, who is Rebecca Skloot? She's the person who decided to write the life story of Henrietta Lacks and ensure it was told the right way. The Lacks family was a bit hesitant of this at first, but eventually one of Lacks' daughters came on board and helped explain everything. The money that Skloot's made from the book, as well as speaking events, actually goes to the foundation to ensure that the Lacks family can provide for one another. Number 6. She was forced to go to Johns Hopkins Hospital. One of the greatest ironies of the situation Henrietta Lacks found herself in was that Johns Hopkins Hospital was the one who took her cells and started shipping them all over the world. But the only reason she went to Johns Hopkins Hospital in the first place was because it was the only hospital in the area of Roanoke, Virginia that treated African-American patients. It was a very different United States back then, and because of that, whites and blacks were segregated. Hospitals, which are a sanctuary of sorts today, weren't treated with the same level of equality back then. And you have to wonder, what would have happened if Lacks were able to go to a different hospital? Would her cells have been stolen there? I guess we'll never know. Number 5. HBO Documentary. You know your story is important to the history of the world when HBO, or another big network, wants to make a movie about it. And that's exactly what happened with Henrietta Lacks, though she wasn't able to see the movie herself, obviously, as she passed away decades before it was made. The movie was made in part by Oprah Winfrey herself, which helped bring a lot of public attention to the film, and the documentary even made it to some award shows and got many victories in their categories. The Immortal Life of Henrietta Lacks came out in 2017 and can be viewed now if you have the right service. Number 4. The family wasn't happy about the movie. That being said, while it did bring a lot of attention to the issue of the HeLa cells and the shady dealings that went on to get them, the Lacks family was not too happy about the endeavor. Mainly, Henrietta Lacks' son, who believed that HBO made the movie solely to get profit and attention, which he said was proven because the Lacks family did not get any of the money that the film helped acquire, which you would think they would have done because of the importance of the family to the story. But that's not the case. It should also be noted that the BBC also did a piece on Henrietta Lacks and also got praise for it. Number 3. The reason for immortality. After hearing all of what Henrietta cells could do, are you curious as to why they could do that at all? Well, the answer was discovered only very recently. University of Washington researchers found that a scrambled HPV genome inserted itself near an oncogene in Henrietta's genome, which activated the oncogene and caused a rapid replication of the HeLa cells in Henrietta's body. Or, in simple terms, a genetic defect happened and occurred in such a way that it caused the unusual cell happenings of Lacks. As one might say, happy accidents. But what was this accident, you ask? Well, her cells, unlike any ever collected before, are continually reproducing at an alarming rate, even outside of her body. To this day, her cells are continuing to be reproduced, which is allowing them to be sold and shipped to scientists all around the world. Number 2. Patient rights. Aside from the obvious medical benefits that her immortal cells have had, the story of Henrietta Lacks is one that is being shared all over the world now, and medical facilities from all over are being kept in check by ensuring that any cultures, cells, and other remnants of the human body are only taken by doctors with permission. This way, no one else can be taken advantage of like Lacks was. Number 1. The treatment was a misdiagnosis. One last irony before you go. When Henrietta Lacks went to Johns Hopkins Hospital to get treated, they initially misdiagnosed her. She went into the hospital about abdominal pain as well as unusual bleeding in certain areas. After being seen by a doctor, she was diagnosed with terminal cervical cancer, which is not something you want to have in any way. This was the diagnosis due to a tumor that was found on her cervix. But in fact, what she had was another type of cancer called adenocarcinoma, which is a gland that grows on the glands of a human body. It's still bad though, and she did indeed pass away in the hospital after months of attempted treatments. She was buried in an unmarked family grave in Virginia. Have you heard the story of Henrietta Lacks before? What are your thoughts on what happened to her and her family? Let us know in the comments below, and take care.